Huh? Tell us, Chris Nelson.
My name's Chris Nelson. I live at our own property, 8775, County Road 73, Mont Valley, which is pretty much right near Ashby. It's on the Shelton County side, but right near Bibb County. I've been going around to different towns and municipalities in Bibb, Shelton, and Shelby counties to kind of speak on the proposed prison that's slated to be built in Ashby, Briarfield area. So I have some information I want to present to you guys, just to make you aware of it, if you're not already. There's a map there that has a approximate site of where the prison will be located. Also in that packet, there's an article from the Centreville Press that has a breakdown of a meeting that occurred in early September that goes into some resident concerns about the prison. We've been running ads in the Montevallo Chamber Chatter and other media outlets to encourage people to contact their local representatives to voice their concerns about the prison. And we've been working with organizations throughout the state that were concerned about some issues. So if you'll allow me to read just a brief statement to kind of go into some details about it. On September 3rd, Governor Kay Ivey revealed that confidential negotiations were in the works with private developers to build a 3,100 inmate prison in Briarfield. It's one of three large prisons the Ivey administration plans to develop to replace most of the state's aging, overcrowded prisons. The others are slated for Elmore and Escambia counties. Ivey is trying a different approach, hiring private developers to finance, build, and maintain the prisons, and then lease them to the state, a plan that does not require legislative approval. The use of private developers and confidential negotiations have limited public access to information about the projects. And no one in Briarfield had any idea that the prisons were going to be built there until the governor's press release on September 3rd. So one reason I wanted to come before the Centreville City Council today was to ask that you guys would make a request of the governor's office or the Department of Corrections or any engineering firms. Because the construction of this prison will affect traffic flow and density through highways 82, 5, and 25, which run through Centreville. I would think the city would be privy to any traffic studies, environmental impact statements, public safety concerns, or comments from landowners and residents. Because this prison will require a substantial supply of potable water, and Centreville is the most readily available municipal source, it's in the interest of maintaining existing levels of service, the city should inform its citizens of any intent to provide the resource to the facility. If the current water system requires additional capacity to do so, the city should disclose how this expansion will be supported and funded. Plans for the installation of maintenance and supply lines and pumping stations should also be available for review. And likewise, any improvements to utilities for wastewater and sewage management for the facility should be made public record. I'd also ask that the city consider appointing a representative to coordinate with interested parties for and against the prison and to keep the city informed on both sides of the issue. I'd ask the city to work with city and town council and county commission members from each affected county. I've spoken to the town of Wilton council. I went to Montevallo City Council. Clara City Council. I went to the Shelton County Commission. I've been twice to the Bibb County Commission. There's several others that I want to hit before I visit everyone. But basically, I'm asking that you guys work together to collect information and share it with each other and ask the state to provide you more information so you can make an informed decision on if the proposed prison is in the best interest of the community. Once that group is established, I would ask that they be empowered to solicit opinions of experts on the topics of for-profit incarceration, environmental and social impacts of rural prisons, the validity of claimed economic benefit and other related concerns. And finally, I would ask that the council, in coordination with other cities and towns in the counties, request that the state delay any movement on contracts or land purchases until the group is able to compile the public report and submit it. So there were a fair number of concerns that residents of Briarfield had in regards to the prison. I can just run through some of those briefly so you guys will be aware. The meeting focused on the impact of the prison that it may have on services such as medical care, EMS, fire departments, law enforcement, utilities, roads, and bridges. Also mentioned what will be done with garbage that will be generated as the current landfill, the one that services Briarfield, is little more than a transfer station and will likely not be able to handle the additional waste. Concerns included not only the strain on current public services, but on where water will come from for the prison, how much will be needed, how sewage will be handled, so that, as I said a few minutes ago. So far, Block the Briarfield Prison, which is the group I'm working with, has requested state oversight on decision-making because the process has been so secretive, with no opportunity for citizens, stakeholders, or lawmakers to express concerns or provide input or gain information. In addition to having contacted the governor's office, the group has also reached out to Senator Cam Ward. And I don't know if you guys are aware, but today it was announced that Cam Ward will be taking a position as the, on the board of parole for the state prison. So there's going to be a vacancy, I would assume, in early December for the state Senate District 14. So I'm guessing they're going to call a special election. So there's another issue to consider. The new representative will be elected. It'll be up to him to kind of coordinate this. I had spoke to Cam personally when I attended the City of Alabaster City Council meeting and asked him if he was aware of any of the details of the plan. He told me that he only knew as much that was in the papers. So I'm not sure who at the governor's office or Department of Corrections has a timeline or what kind of agenda they're following. But if Cam Ward didn't know about it, I'm not sure who does. So that's another reason that I think you guys should have that information available to you. Very little information has been provided from either the governor or the ADOC, which is Alabama Department of Corrections. What has been said that there will be a 30-year lease agreement with annual renewals. In the press release the governor Ivey sent out last week, she stated the developers were well aware of the $88 million affordability limit for the annual lease payments, and the state does not intend to increase that limit year over year. So the state will pay the private company to build the prisons, and then they'll lease services from that company for a 30-year period, but the contract will be renegotiated every year. So there's no guarantee that the cost or the what the state will have to pay this private corporation won't increase. So really it's just an estimate that $88 million a year. The citizens of the meeting understand that $88 million lease payments will cover the mega prisons, but the question of where the funding will come from was included. A member of one of the volunteer groups stated that in order to turn a profit, an ADOC representative said the prisons would have to maintain 120% occupancy. So one of the proposed reasons for building these prisons is to reduce overcrowding in the current facilities. But to maintain profitability, the private corporations will have to essentially overcrowd their facilities or run them at a capacity higher than is recommended to maintain that level. So it's not really solving that issue. There's several more issues included in the article. The one from the Centreville Press, I think, was pretty thorough in everything it covered. In particular, the issues related to Brent. It's not confirmed, but it's believed that if this new facility opens, they'll eventually transition the majority of the prisoners out of the Brent facility and close it or repurpose it. So the city of Brent will lose a significant amount of revenue because they provide water services and then tax money that they generate from people who work at the prison there and other benefits that they receive. So
why would they build one prison and then gradually close another one up? That confuses me.
The rationale they give is they said the Brent prison cannot be expanded or repaired, but that's an open question. They claim that it was, I don't know if it's issues with the way it was built. They say it's built on a swamp.
Swampland mitigation. I talked to the engineering group that built the prison. He said they had to go down there with the Department of Engineer folks. He said he had armed guards with him because of snakes. You know, it's in the bottomlands of the Cobble River down there. We used
to duck
hunt down
there. Well, that would be a deterrent to not, to, you know, keep yourself straight. Don't
wind ain't up no doubt, bridge, buddy. Hey, alligators snakes in the swamp.
But in this article, I think it's Jerry Powell said that the entire city of Brent has that same issue. So if that's the case, why did the Department of Corrections pick that site 23-odd years ago to build there?
Well, the city of Brent doesn't really have that same issue.
Well, that was his claim.
Yeah.
You can take it with him, I guess. But that Cam Ward spoke in the article here. They said if they do build this new facility, they will close the Brent facility. So I imagine that would affect you guys as well, since you're kind of, that's your sister city is right next door. So these are all issues to consider. I just wanted to bring it to your attention, and my email address is on the first page where I kind of broke down the one right after the map. You can reach out to me, and then that ad you see there, in our backyard, at the bottom, it has a web address to the this Thursday night at 6:30, there's gonna be a community meeting at Ashby Baptist Church on Highway 139, right in Briarfield, near County Road 2. So Ashby Baptist Church is basically gonna be right next door to the new prison, as best we can tell. That's Westerville land, it's about 350 acres. So I've been meeting with those folks, just trying to let them know what's coming. So there's some local people that are gonna be having a meeting there tomorrow night, and I've been inviting mayors and city council members to come and voice their concerns, and they've also invited Cam Ward, although I'm not sure if he's gonna be around, and someone representing the governor's office, and also someone from the Department of Corrections. Hopefully they'll be there to answer questions.
And what's the date of that meeting?
That's this coming Thursday, 6:30. At Ashby Baptist. But if any of y'all have any other questions, feel free to reach out to me. No.
First of all, I've been here in Centreville for a while, a few years. Mm-hmm. And to my knowledge, we Centreville, we haven't had no big issues or problems with the bib corrections. Now, the police department has assisted the Brent Police Department in assisting the corrections officers and so forth. Mm-hmm. We've had, as far as we, the city of Centreville, as far as law enforcement, has benefited tremendously from that state prison.
Part of the concern, I guess, the folks in Briarfield have is very undeveloped portion of the county is unincorporated currently. Where they plan on building the prison, there's no.
I know exactly where it's going to be.
Yeah.
I know exactly that goes Westbound. But what I'm saying is, to my problem, thinking, like I said, we haven't had any difficulties with the prison. As a matter of fact, they have helped us out tremendously with picking up litter, helping keeping the city of Centreville clean, mm-hmm. the side of the road and so forth.
Painting schools?
Absolutely.
Tracking dogs?
Tracking dogs to run down criminals and so forth. Now, take it. No, I wouldn't want a state prison next to my house or my land. Mm-hmm. The reason they building this prison is consolidate all these smaller prisons into one big facility, which will be three, as I understand it, across the state of Alabama.
When they built the Brent prison, that was before my time, but then they had a public comment period. There was like the state handled the construction, so there was hearings.
That's right, which we're supposed to be in, right.
Yeah, how it's working now is no public information has been released, and it's gonna be built privately, so there'll be no, unless there's a lawsuit, are there some way to force the state or the companies building the prison to release these plans? We have no idea what it's going to be, the size of it, what it's going to affect.
Yeah.
So if the state is to claim that this is going to be economically beneficial to Briarfield, then why aren't they doing it in an open and transparent way like they did with Brent?
I feel like it will be beneficial to the area as far as internet service, utilities, and you know, along them lines. Like I said again, there, you know, I wouldn't want it next to my property, but I don't see where the city of Centreville itself needs to get involved in the talks, deliberations, or whatever about something out in the county when the county commission is not in charge, but over that particular area. In my opinion, we don't need to book the county commission.
Yeah, at the end of the
we
day.
We need to work together, you know, at the end of the day. That's
right. Yeah. And we are. You know, I've talked to Mr. Nelson twice and told him we weren't going to do an agenda item tonight because we'd be wasting city time talking about property 15 miles away.
We are.
But I don't want you to think we're not sympathetic to people. You know, like I know your parents. Your mom, I think, is the chamber director following. Yeah,
she works there.
Yeah, in the chamber in Mono Valley.
My argument is that I know you guys have no political influence over the state or possibly the county, but I know you know people who probably live in the county. You associate the cities around here. You're all interconnected. So
I think what y'all are trying to do is get city councils to pass resolutions against prison.
No, that's not. I'm just saying you can't pretend like a prison 15 miles away from you is.
Oh, we're not. I mean, like I told you the other day, I mean, we would definitely probably benefit from gas, from groceries, from
absolutely,
you know, from traffic in some way, you know, 82 to 36 probably
if,
going up that way,
if
you know.
Prison in Brent, though, has been of such a benefit to you guys. Aren't you afraid of losing it if it doesn't move across the county?
Still stays in the county.
Historically, what's been the problem with the prison in the county? Historically, what? How much trouble do we have?
Well,
for the citizens that live around there?
How, if they're going to say they have to drill a well to get their water because the city of Wilton doesn't have enough capacity to supply approximately 4,000 people in a 3 or 4 or less than that square mile area. So unless they tap on with you guys, which I'm guessing that's not going to happen unless somebody comes with a bunch of money or the state helps you out, they're going to have to drill wells, and that's going to affect all the residents.
And if you tapped into us, it'd be a great benefit to us.
Yeah.
I mean, it'd be a, it's a win-win to us.
Absolutely.
Because what you're talking about, increased traffic, groceries, gas, potential water distribution to another city.
Mm-hmm. But
I mean, it would be a win-win. Now, Brent,
if they were building in your city limits, y'all would have the rights to.
But that's hypothetical.
To vote on it. Out there in the county, we have no recourse.
But the reason they're building it there is because it's remote.
Correct. We can go to the county commission and beg them not to do it. But at the end of the day, they'll just ignore us and do whatever the hell they want to anyway.
City council could do that.
Yeah, but you have a lot more pull when you have a group of people.
See, I was around when the Brent. I mean, I got pictures in the car of the groundbreaking.
Yeah. Now.
And there was a few people that had concerns about what if they break out? What will they break into my house and steal a car?
I'm not worried about there'll be increased crime in the area just because of the prison there, because of the folks that prisons tend to attract. You're going to have people more traffic in the area. It's just a fact that's an issue. But I'm not so much worried about escapes as I am. You're dropping basically a whole new city in a very concentrated area in a spot where there's wilderness currently.
Well,
and if
see, my issue with that though, Chris, is that
then why
Roosevelt's property?
Yeah, why isn't
it's a private?
Why isn't the state coming to us and saying, "Do you want
private?"
This?
It's a private. If I own property, I wouldn't want you to come and tell me what I can do with it.
So if somebody put a hog plant beside your house, you would just say, okay, I'm fine with
it. It's not zoned for hog plants.
Well, if it was?
It wouldn't be.
There's no zoning in the county. You see, we're talking in circles here.
Yeah, but I mean, what you're saying is a plus for us, because the reason it's in a remote location, the reason they built it where it is in Brent,
mm-hmm.
is because there was no population down there. There's people in Brent that do not even know there's a prison in Brent.
Right.
But the economic incentives from that prison have greatly benefited Brent and Centreville and Bibb County.
Well, that's great. I hope you guys can keep it, but it sounds like you're going to lose it.
No, it's still in Bibb County. You know, on the flip side, Barber County's ticked because their prison could close their lot. They lost their prison.
Yeah.
Now, I know, you know, you would go, we'll give it to Barber County.
No, I don't want a new prison. I don't want new prisons built anywhere in Alabama. I think the correct solution is to actually address the issues with the criminal justice system, and then
you think there's too many people being arrested?
Well, the existing prison facilities
for committing crimes that are against the law.
The state has neglected the prison system for so long and let it deteriorate to this point. This is the only option.
There's definitely an overcrowding in prisons now.
I know
where you're coming from,
I believe your
logic is flawed.
Okay.
You know, I mean, that's where I'm coming from. I know where you're coming from, and I know the groups that are behind the block, the Briarfield prison.
Mm-hmm.
There's some radical groups.
I'm not radical.
Well, I'm not calling you. There's groups that are behind it, are funneling money to certain people.
No one's giving me a dime, sir. I paid money. I'm on.
But I mean, that's a scary thing when you know when you
do you have any evidence to back up these assertions, sir?
Absolutely.
Can you show them to me?
Well, look on the picture at that the Briarfield meeting.
What picture is that?
I'm not gonna get it. Well, thank you for your time, Chris.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. It's unlikely you're gonna.
Yeah.
Change our mind.
No doubt.
I'm not here to change my mind.
But you look at the picture from the story of the Briarfield meeting. The groups that were there represented.
Yeah, Okay,
you know, make up.
Email it to me and I'll check it out.
I'll angle you.
But I'm not here to change anybody's mind. I'm just here to let you know we're out there fighting it, and we're gonna keep bugging y'all. So.
No.
Yeah, don't. Yeah, you don't want to bug us.
First of all, don't make threats. Yeah.
No, I'm not making a threat. I
don't appreciate being threatened.
I'm not by bug. I mean, we're gonna keep speaking up at meetings. We're gonna keep speaking out.
That's your priority.
Okay.
County commission, like I said, county commission is the best avenue. That's where we're getting our information. And Cam, you know, he's been a great friend of us. I mean, she and I worked in the school system. For the Lord, she was there for. I was there for 3 years. Yeah. But I mean, he was a great friend of us. Mm-hmm. You know, and as a good guy, he's never let us wrong.
Yeah.
And then I lived in the back. The prison's in the backyard.
Yeah.
Sure we did. Bought sure Stacy's house, and I kind of got. And you know, you don't want one in your backyard, but I moved there knowing it was there. And I really wasn't afraid at all, and it had big advantages. Power went off, my back on just like that. Yeah. You know, but you don't want it in your backyard. I understand that. But I was never afraid.
From my point of view, it's not the backyard issue. I think modern prisons are probably built so well that the odds of somebody escaping is very minimal.
And then if they do escape, they're gonna try to get away.
Yeah.
They ain't gonna hang around backyard.
There's also other issues associated.
But I mean, I understand where you're coming from as far as not wanting it there. Uh-huh. But like we said, we don't have a lot of control of that.
I think it's good that, and you probably see more folks on me around. So I'm just kind of letting you guys know that we're active in this fight, and then we'll keep. I mean, we can disagree politically, we can disagree on the benefits of prisons, but I just appreciate you letting me get up, speak my piece.
It's going to benefit the Model Valley Chamber of Commerce.
I don't believe that's the case.
It will. But thank you, man. I appreciate it.
Thanks.
All right. Anybody else? Motion adjourned.
No.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.